And there is your challenger, Pat Tanaka. It's feature time here on NWA Eastern Championship Wrestling. This match for the ECW Heavyweight Championship. There you see the champion, all the worse for wear from his 45-minute time limit draw with the franchise. Shane Douglas Funk is heavily bandaged, his left arm as well as his forehead. Funk's got the mic.
Am I wrestling you, or am I wrestling Tanaka?
Well, Funk speaking to
Paul
Diamond.
Is he such a child that he needs you at his side? Why don't you go back into the dressing room where you belong? You've never been a wrestler in your entire life. I wrestled for the NWA, and now I'm the ECW champion, and I'm proud of it. Have you, if you've ever done anything that you can be proud of, let it be that you walked out of here and let this man fight his own battle by himself.
Well, Funk is obviously playing a mind game with bad company, both Tanaka and Diamond. I doubt it will work. Both Paul Diamond and Pat Tanaka, a couple of ring veterans, a lot of savvy between them. Of course, neither one of them with the experience of Terry Funk. And Terry Funk goes to work on Pat Tanaka. Pat Tanaka now being worked over by Funk. Tanaka thrown from the ring. And remember, should Tanaka win this match and become the ECW Heavyweight Champion, I don't know, would that mean he goes into this the three-way match on February 5th? I mean, that would just throw the title picture into absolute turmoil. So many questions arise. Tanaka could just really blow the ECW apart by winning the title tonight, and quite frankly, he's got all the credentials to do it. Funk now laying in punches to the sensei, Pat Tanaka. Paul Diamond looking on from the outside, and Funk joining it up with Paul Diamond. Tanaka, a little glassy-eyed from the onset, beats the guardrail head first. Terry Funk, obviously still injured from his match with the franchise. Shane Douglas, still battered, still bruised, must get the win any way he can, including using the guardrail, using the ring post, using any and all opportunities, any advantages to put down Pat Tanaka, who could very well be the new ECW Heavyweight Champion by the end of tonight. And Funk now peppering Tanaka with a series of lefts and a roundhouse that drops Tanaka. Funk really in control early on. He's going for a pile driver. Funk going for the pile driver. Will he? Yes! He hit! That's it. The match just like that. Terry Funk has defended his title. One, two, and oh! Oh my goodness! Tanaka up at about 2 7/8. Tanaka, I don't know where he got that from. And Funk about to whack the referee. Oh, go ahead. You'd be fined and suspended. You'd be home on February 5th. And Tanaka again thrown from the ring. You know, you've got to wonder what Tanaka and Diamond are thinking. They've got their shot at the ECW Tag Team titles on Saturday night, February 5th. They're going to face Sullivan and the Tasman. And speaking of Sullivan, you know, he devolved... Wait a minute! Funk, forget Sullivan! Funk is now choking Tanaka with tape that he took off his own arm. Choking out Pat Tanaka. Come on, ref, get him off of him! Look at the look in Terry Funk's eyes. He's berserk. This man is nuts. As I was saying, earlier on, Kevin Sullivan divulged the secret here in wrestling. I mean, we all know of wrestlers who are sons of promoters, like Eric Watts, Jeff Jarrett, Greg Gagne. What Kevin Sullivan divulged here on ECW television, is that Pat Tanaka is the son of Duke Kiyomuka, who promoted wrestling with Eddie Wait, and Tanaka firing back. Almost as if he heard his father's name, if he could hear me from the Eagle's Nest. Tanaka all of a sudden fired up, and now it is the challenger sending the champion sprawling to the floor. But Tanaka is the son of Duke Kiyomuka, who had an impeccable reputation as a wrestler and a promoter in Florida. And what Kevin Sullivan said about Duke being a thief, it doesn't deserve an answer. It was deplorable. It was in bad taste, and quite frankly, Sullivan's going to pay just like Funk is paying right now. Just like Pat Tanaka is working. Whoa! And Tanaka using his hands and his feet. Those feet are weapons on Funk, who was walking around ringside a little funny after Pat Tanaka was laying in shots to every part of Funk's body. Now, Tanaka dragging Funk back in the ring. Challenger shoots at the champion. Touchdown, Funk, up and over. Oh, double chop by Tanaka. Cover that, man, cover. One, two, and three, yes, yes. Oh, no, two only. I thought for 1 second, I thought that Pat Tanaka had become easy. Wait a minute, that's Ian Rott. That's it, that's Terry Funk's two good men. Paul Diamond out there with Ian Rott. But cover, two, and yo, oh, no. Tanaka's so close. Come on, Pat. Go for it. Go for it all. As Paul Diamond fighting off the bad breed, the few good men, the Ruttons, whatever you want to call them. Paul Diamond is keeping Funk's henchmen at bay as Tanaka lays in a headbutt on Funk, who I believe we are seeing his ECW title slip away. Wait a minute. There's Tasmaniac and Sullivan. They just floored Paul Diamond. Tanaka went to help his partner. He was rolled up by Funk. Funk with a handful of tights gets the victory. Tanaka doesn't care about the match. He's going out to help his partner. And here comes Diamond and Tanaka fighting against the Tasmaniac and Kevin Sullivan. They don't want to wait till February 5th. Meanwhile, in the ring, Terry Funk. Oh, my! The fight continues, and Funk will go into February 5th as the ECW Heavyweight Champion.